Hey guys, welcome to Tips from the Dyeing Studio. For this episode, I am gonna do a little bit of an unboxing. I've never done an unboxing video before, and it's because this just arrived today, so I figured this is a perfect opportunity to share a little bit of an unboxing with you guys in regards to tools that can be used in the dyeing studio. So today, I am gonna be unboxing a Vantacool pH meter. So a pH meter is really useful in the dyeing studio when you're, especially when you're dyeing multiple batches of yarn and recycling a lot of exhausted dye water. This is a really great way to check the pH of the dye water before doing it in another batch, so you know that you're not working with too acidic of water, and you also know when you need to add some baking soda to bring that back down to a more neutral state. So it's really important to have one of these, or strips. You can use pH strips as well in the dyeing studio, but I have never used a meter like this, and I'm super excited to give it a shot. So let's go ahead and open it up and see what we have. Okay, so here it is. This is the Vantacool pH, a high accuracy water quality tester. It's pretty much a pH meter, which is exactly what I need. I typically use pH strips, but I ran out of pH strips and I figured this is a much more economical way of doing that because I don't need to keep going through strips over and over and over again every single time I'm testing out a new pan of water. So this is really good for me. So that is what I got this for. So let's go ahead and open it up and see what we have. Okay, so as soon as you open it, you are greeted by a really cool plastic case. So it comes in its own plastic case. There we go. So we have instructions and the meter itself. So here is the pH meter. This is what it looks like. It's pretty cool. It's got a little pin clip on the back, so you can attach it to an apron. You can stick it on the rim of a pan or a pot if you need it like that, but I think this is more for attaching it to your apron. Super helpful. That's the screen. If I turn it on, there we go. I'm not sure if this is just a calibration button or what, but we'll look into that in just a second. So then if I pop off the protective cap, that is the business end of the meter right there. Let's make sure it's focusing for you. There we go. So pretty cool so far. Let's go ahead and find out a little bit more about this bad boy. So we have, as I read this, this is the electrode that is used to detect the pH level of the water. And then we have, yep, the calibration button right here, the on and off switch. This is the display screen. And then the battery compartment is up here. And then that is our protective cap. All right, so let's go ahead and give it a try. It says that the first thing you need to do is rinse off the electrode in clear water. So I have a little jar over here of clear water. I'm just gonna give this a good rinse. Okay, let's dry it off. So the way that I would use this is, like I mentioned, if I have a pot of water that I've just finished using for dyeing yarn, all of the dye is exhausted, I want to make sure that there's not any residual acid left over, and that can throw off your next batch, and so you really want to bring that water back down to a neutral state using baking soda, which we'll talk about in a second. But this is a really great way to check your water to make sure, number one, is it acidic enough to dye the yarn, and then when you're all done dyeing and you're recycling the water, is it neutral enough to start a new lot of yarn in this without it throwing off your colorway any. So let's go ahead and see how this works. So this is water left off from our solar dyed yarn. It has not been neutralized. I haven't gotten to that yet, so I'm going to check it now. It's a perfect opportunity to check it now, so we're going to check it for its pH level, and then we will neutralize it and see what happens. And then over here I have, again, just basic clear tap water, so we're going to go ahead and check the pH of each of these and see what we get. Okay, so on and off. And I'm going to wait for about 30 seconds. Okay, it's been about 30 seconds. Let's go ahead and check the reading. I don't want to pull it out of the water too much, so I'm going to kind of tilt this so you can see the reading. Yeah, so we are at a 7.5, which is just below neutral on the pH scale. Okay, so that means that the tap water is relatively neutral. Now let's go ahead and try what was left of that dye stock water, which has no dye in it at this point, but I'm sure there's still some residual acid, so let's go ahead and check that. Turn it on. insert it into the water, stir it around a little bit. Okay, and then we're gonna wait about 30 seconds. All right, so let's go ahead and take a look. The reading for this water here, you can see is 2, just a little smidge over 2. 2 is really acidic on the scale. Typically, when I dye my yarn, I like to keep my pH level at a 4. That's optimal for dyeing yarn, but if you remember from the previous episode of the vlog where we solar dyed skeins of yarn, I actually doubled the dose of citric acid that I typically do, so this is pretty expected considering that. So whatever would be left over in the pan would definitely be higher than what I would typically do for dyeing yarn, but that's that. So that is my leftover dye stock water. It is pretty acidic. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna use just plain baking soda, not a sponsor, plain baking soda, and I'm gonna just add a dash of this to this water to help neutralize and bring it down. And you don't have to add a lot. A little of this goes a long way when it comes to neutralizing some water. So let's go ahead and add a dash of this. There we go. We'll mix it around. I think I added more than a dash, but it's okay. It'll do the trick. So if I have a pot that I'm gonna be reusing for another lot of yarn, I will take and just dash it with baking soda to bring it back down to neutral before adding the new addition of acid, because I like to measure out my acids for each of my colorways. It kind of keeps my colorways looking the same as much as possible. And so I like to bring that water back down to neutral and then add my new acid to the water. Okay, so now that we've added baking soda to this, let's go ahead and check it. I'm gonna stick this in, swirl it around. We're looking for something close to 8, as much as we can get it, okay? And let's go ahead and leave it for 30 seconds. So it looks like our final reading is 7.19, and it's fluctuating just a little bit, but we're about 7. That's not bad. That's pretty neutral. It's definitely in the neutral range when it comes to dyeing yarn. That would be totally suitable for moving on to another dyeing solution. It's definitely not acidic enough for it to matter. So I'm gonna go ahead and rinse this off in clear water. Give it a dry, replace my protective cap, and add it back to my case. So there you have it, guys, the Vanicool pH meter. Definitely not a sponsor, just excited about a new toy to play with in the dyeing studio. So there you have it, folks, my very first unboxing. So if you're in the market for something new to test the pH of your dyeing water, check it out. Amazon, like 13 bucks. Not bad.